The project is funded by the Norwegian Agency for Cooperation and Development and the FAO. According to the island's Deputy Chief Fisheries Officer, St. Lucia is vulnerable to climate change, particularly at the fisheries sector because it is marine-based.
We have had over the years the issue of the sargassum influx that continues to affect fisherfolk around the island. We do have the issue of coral bleaching, and certainly we have seen kind of peaks and troughs in terms of the landings of fish around the island. So as I said, the other thing, of course, that's worth noting is the intensity and frequency of hurricanes and storms. And as I said, because fishers depend on the marine environment for livelihood, the marine environment is very exposed to the impacts of climate change.
Therefore, Mr. Nelson says, it is extremely important that we adapt to climate change by increasing our resilience towards these impacts and see how best we can make more positive changes. With the global project funded by the government of Norway, FAO's Florence Paulin says St. Lucia has been identified as a beneficiary country.
There's a series of issues affecting fisheries in the world, and climate change is making these issues is making these issues worse. Yeah. So we had a review which was done by my colleague saying that the Caribbean were among the worst affected by climate change. So we think it's important to target climate change and adaptation specifically in the Caribbean.
The event was attended by representatives of the OECS Commission, fishers, Seamoss Farmers, officials of the Environmental Health Department, the TVET Council, and other stakeholders. It was held at the Bellevue Hotel. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.